Hello everybody, my name is David Arena and I work in the 3D scanning team here at GoEngineer. Today we're going to have a brief look at Creaform's VX Element software with respect to a function called Smart Resolution. This function applies multiple resolution levels to the scan instead of a single resolution. It helps to use the adequate resolution on a surface that has different geometries. For instance, high curvature surfaces require a higher resolution in order to represent better the details, opposed to a flat surface that may require a coarser resolution. Smart Resolution uses raw images stored in a session to create different resolution levels. This function is available with the GoScan Spark, the HandySCAN Black series, and MetraSCAN Black series of scanners. Let's take a look. So here we have a scan of a form die. And currently, when I scanned this part, I scanned it at a resolution of 30,000ths of an inch. That basically means that the triangle spacing on the mesh is approximately 30,000ths apart from each other, and the smart resolution is turned off. So that means I'm going to have a consistent resolution. So if I go ahead and turn on the wireframe and triangles here, you can see that the triangles are fairly equilateral, and there is not any smart resolution currently being applied, so I have a uniform 30,000 spacing resolution. So I'm going to go ahead and turn on the standard resolution, and what's going to happen here is it's going to take this input resolution of 30,000ths and it's going to keep that where it's needed, and on the higher curvature areas of the scan it's going to apply half of that resolution, though it's going to be approximately 15,000ths of an inch. Let's take a look at that. So we just changed the smart resolution from off to standard. So again, that means it's going to be the input resolution and then half of that as needed. I'm going to go ahead and turn on the wireframe here. And you can see as I zoom in a little bit that the 30,000ths is applied on the flatter areas, and where the curvature gets sharper on the scan, that the triangles are a smaller resolution to accommodate that curvature. So you can see there's more detail. So we have basically two resolutions currently on this scan. Let's take a look at applying a third resolution. Okay, so we just changed the smart resolution from standard to high here, you can see. So now we're going to have three resolutions. We're going to have the input resolution of 30,000. We're going to have half of that, 15,000ths. And the third resolution is going to be approximately half of 15,000. So approximately 7 to 8 thousandths of an inch. Go ahead and turn on the wireframe. And you can see here that we've got the input resolution again, about 30,000ths. Then in here, we're going to have a secondary resolution, and the third resolution on this higher curvature here of these lettering is going to be applied where it's necessary. So you can see we have a nice, crisp, multi-resolution scan here, and let's look at some of our other options we can do. So here I've changed the smart resolution to custom, which allows for three different levels of resolution. You can see I still have the input resolution here. I can do two finer resolutions. I can also do two coarser resolutions, and currently I have it set to one coarser and one finer. So what that's going to do is basically it's going to double the resolution in the flatter areas, and it's going to also include the input resolution of about 30,000ths, and it's going to have the finer resolution of half of 30,000. So you can see that here it's about 60,000ths resolution here. In this area it's about 30,000ths, and then again on the lettering it's 15,000ths. So all the changes that I've done here in this dialog box apply globally to the entire scan. Let's look at other options of applying smart resolution. So another way to achieve a multi-resolution scan is to apply these multi-resolutions locally based on your selection. For example, if I go ahead and use this selection tool here, I'm going to go ahead and select this lettering like so, and here I can change the resolution manually. I have some options here. I can go 8 times finer, 4 times finer, or 2 times finer. So let's look at what 8 times looks like. I'll go ahead and apply that. Next I'll change it to 4 and select a different area. Let's say this lettering here. I'm going to change that from a multiplier of 4. And lastly I'll change it to 2 times the resolution. And I'll select this feature here. So this is a result of applying the manual resolution to locally selected areas. You can see that I've got the high detail here, 8 times the resolution. I've got the resolution here about 4 times the resolution of the input value. And here I've increased the resolution by doubling the input resolution. So this manual selection of changing the resolution could come in handy when you have a very large part and you don't need high detail everywhere. You just need to have detail on features that require higher detail, allows you to select those areas and apply that new resolution. So that's about it for the smart resolution and some of the options you have using this function. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye for now.